أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. تنزيل العزيز الرحيم. لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون. لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون. وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون. وسواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب فبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم. إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون. إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم. قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون. أأتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغني عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون. إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين. إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون. قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. بما غفر لي ربي وجعلني من المكرمين. وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينذرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم قل يحييها الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون صدق الله العظيم اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله يا الله يا الله. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله 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 العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل 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 فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم، يا حليم يا عليم، أنت ربي وعلمك حسبي، فنعم الرب ربي ونعم الحسب حسبي، تنصر من تشاء وأنت العزيز الرحيم. نسألك العصمة في الحركات والسكنات والكلمات والإرادات والخطرات، من الشكوك والظنون والأوهام الساترة للقلوب عن مطالعة الغيوب. فقد ابتلي المؤمنون وزلزلوا زلزالا شديدا، وإذ يقول المنافقون والذين في قلوبهم مرض ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. فثبتنا وانصرنا وسخر لنا هذا البحر كما سخرت البحر لموسى، وسخرت النار لإبراهيم، وسخرت الجبال والحديد لداود، وسخرت الريح والشياطين والجن لسليمان. وسخر لنا كل بحر هو لك في الأرض والسماء والملك والملكوت، وبحر الدنيا وبحر الآخرة. وسخر لنا كل شيء، يا من بيده ملكوت كل شيء. كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد. انصرنا فإنك خير الناصرين، وافتح لنا فإنك خير الفاتحين، واغفر لنا فإنك خير الغافرين، وارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين، وارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين، واهدنا ونجنا من القوم الظالمين، وهب لنا ريحا طيبة كما هي في علمك، وانشرها علينا من خزائن رحمتك، واحملنا بها حمل الكرامة مع السلامة والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا مع الراحة لقلوبنا وأبداننا والسلامة والعافية في دنيانا وديننا وكن لنا صاحبا في سفرنا وخليفة في أهلنا واطمس على وجوه أعدائنا وامسخهم على مكانتهم فلا يستطيعون المضي ولا المجيء إلينا ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما طاسين حاميم عين سين قاف مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان حاميم 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 هم الأمر وجاء النصر فعلينا لا ينصرون حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير بسم الله بابنا تبارك حيطاننا ياسين سقفنا كاف ها يا عين صاد كفايتنا حاميم عين سين قاف حمايتنا فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم ستر العرش مسبول علينا وعين الله ناظرة إلينا بحول الله لا يقدر علينا والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز يا لطيف 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 لطيف يا 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 لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ألطف بنا لطفا يليق بكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا من جعلت الصلاة على النبي من القربات نتقرب إليك بكل صلاة سليت عليه من أول النشأة إلى ما لا نهاية من الكمالات بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك.
إن شاء الله we'll continue with ذكر الجامعة. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ Inshallah, we'll make dua now. اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our Shaykh, teacher, Murshid, and Master Sayyidina Shaykh Faisal Hamid Abdul Razak. O Allah, may you increase him in knowledge and wisdom. O Allah, may you protect him from evil, and we pray that he will lead his murids on the straight path towards you. O Allah, we pray for the Shaykh and his family. We pray that you strengthen them in Iman, keep them in good health, and grant them long life in Islam. O Allah, we pray that you protect them from all evil, ease their trials, and grant them the sweetness of paradise. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Allah forgive us for our sins and guide us on the straight path leading to paradise. O Allah, you know the needs of all of us present here. O Allah, answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our parents that you grant them your grace and mercy as they raised us in childhood. O Allah, grant our parents long life and good health in Islam. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive our parents and grant them paradise. O Allah, for our parents who have passed away and returned to you, O Allah, we beg you to forgive them. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the murids of Shaykh Faisal throughout the world. O Allah, we pray that you ease our trials and grant us the strength to face our trials. O Allah, make it easy for us to gain true knowledge and to practice it, to be good murids and to get ever closer to you. O Allah, you know the needs of all of the murids. O Allah, we beg you to answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the Muslims around the world. O Allah, we pray that you strengthen us in Iman. O Allah, we pray for unity and to make us stronger as a nation. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, please comfort and relieve all Muslims who are suffering and have suffered losses. O Allah, you are the all-powerful and the almighty. O Allah, we beg you to give us victory against the unbelievers. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for the International Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl and Dhikr Halaqa. May you make it easy for us to establish many masjids for your sake. May you bless the Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl Dhikr Halaqa to be a beacon of light for Islam throughout the world. And may you help us to finish building the new masjid soon and make it easy for us to do so. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadan wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursani walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد صاحب التاج والمعراج والبراك والعلم دافع البلاء والوباء والقحط والمرض والألم اسمه مكتوب مرفوع مشفوع منكوش في اللوح والقلم سيد العرب والعجم جسمه مقدس معتر مطهر منور في البيت والحرم شمس الضحى بدر الدجى صدر العلا نور الهدى كهف الورى مصباح الظلم جميل الشيم شفيع الأمم صاحب الجود والكرم والله عاصمه وجبريل خادمه والبراك مركبه والمعراج سفره وسدرة المنتهى مقامه وقاب قوسين مطلوبه والمطلوب مقصوده والمقصود موجوده سيد المرسلين خاتم النبيين شفيع المذنبين أنيس الغريبين رحمة للعالمين راحة العاشقين مراد المشتاقين شمس العارفين سراج السالكين مصباح المقربين محب الفقراء والغرباء والمساكين سيد الثقلين نبي الحرمين إمام القبلتين وسيلتنا في الدارين وسيلتنا في الدارين صاحب قاب قوسين محبوب رب المشرقين والمغربين جد الحسن والحسين جد الحسن والحسين مولانا ومولى الثقلين أبي القاسم محمد بن عبد الله نور من نور الله نور من نور الله يا أيها المشتاقون بنور جماله صلوا عليه وآله وأصحابه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين، ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين، وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا. اللهم أعذنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، وأصلح لنا شأننا كله، لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. آمين آمين. أما بعد، my dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear murids, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this special program coming to you from the Islamic Forum of Canada, where we share with you this message of mercy from God Almighty to all of His creation. This is our daily broadcast. We start at 7 p.m. Toronto time or Eastern time every day. And we come to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum. We thank you for joining us today for our broadcast. And we hope you can join us every day for this program, 7 p.m. Toronto time. We kindly request you to reach out to others, to tell your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims that you know to watch the program. Share the YouTube link with them, youtube.com/Sheikh Faisal. And inshallah, they will look at the program, they will benefit, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do remember to subscribe to the channel. There's a subscribe button. You click on that button to subscribe. And then next to the subscribe button, there's a bell icon. Click on the bell icon and select all for notifications so that you'll be notified of all our different programs. We also kindly request you to enter your information in the chat, your name and city where you're from, and then your updates on the three projects: the Gratitude Project, the Salawat Project, and the Quran Project. You enter your update on the project, inshallah, the three projects. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. We want to recognize all the sponsors for the dinner program, all those families and especially sisters that have sponsored the dinner program. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. And we want to recognize as well all our donors, those who donated today and yesterday and before to the Islamic Forum. And we make special dua for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all our donors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer the dua and grant them special blessings and ni'mah and bounties and grace our donors and their families and loved ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and increase them in His bounties, increase them in His risk, grant them more wealth, much more than what they donate to the Islamic Forum. So we make special dua for all our donors, and we thank them and we appreciate their financial support for the Islamic Forum. I also want to remind you what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in the hadith, ma naqasa malin bi sadaqa. Your wealth will never decrease because of spending it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma naqasa malin bi sadaqa. The sadaqa that you give will never cause your wealth to decrease. It will increase your wealth. And the scholars have said that your wealth doesn't decrease. It means indeed, certainly, surely your wealth will increase. This is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ma naqasa malin bi sadaqa. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the hadith. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ayatul infaq, the ayah of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will never attain true piety, birr, unless and until you spend what you love. You spend a portion of your wealth for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we invite you to donate regularly and generously to the Islamic Forum, and we make special dua for you. I also want to reassure you that your safety, your well-being, your health, as well as your spirituality, that's the concern of our program. This program focuses on taking care of your safety, your well-being, your afia, as well as your spirituality, that you can be in good health and you can be safe and you can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from all sources of harm. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you that great blessing of spirituality, your connection with Him, your connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so every day we make this special dua for you, for your safety, your spirituality and so on, that you can be granted the goodness of this world and the goodness of the hereafter. And that's the comprehensive dua for the believers that's mentioned in the Quran. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. This is a comprehensive dua. It's called a dua al-jami'a, the comprehensive dua, because it contains everything you can ask for to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's contained in this dua, the comprehensive dua. We also have a special series of beautiful short video clips prepared by our staff here at the Islamic Forum for your viewing, enjoyment and benefit. Short video clips of interesting, relevant, beautiful topics that you can benefit from and you can share with others. As well as we have a special series of video lectures on the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And all of that is a gift for you, free of charge. It's for anyone, inshallah. So if you would like to receive these special video clips and a special series of seerah lectures, then please send us your email address so we can send it to you, inshallah. Beautiful video clips and video lectures that our staff have prepared especially for you. I would like now to make a special dua for each and every one of you. Dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday and before, all our donors without exception. And then special dua for the sponsors of our dinner program. And then special dua for all those who entered their information in the chat. And for each and every one of you, I want to make special dua for each and every one of you. Whatever dua you want to make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put that niyyah in your heart for that dua, and we'll make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on your niyyah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can accept your dua and grant you everything you ask for. And also, I want to include in my dua for my family and my parents, my mother and my father, May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, and please do mention them and remember them in your dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for so doing. So kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. A'udhu billahi samil alim min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahi r-Rahmani r-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب دعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in tawfiq and in qubul and in ziyada. Ameen, ameen. I also want to remind you of our ongoing projects, the action item we have ongoing for our program, the three projects, the gratitude project, the salawat project, and the Quran project. For you to engage in these projects regularly on a daily basis, and then you enter your update in the chat, inshallah. Today I want to say something about the Salawat project, to focus on the Salawat project, to talk something about the beautiful, amazing virtues of Salawat on the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to recite Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin abdika wa rasulika nabiyyil ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Many are the great virtues of Salawat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran the ayah of Salawat in Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 56, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim,
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. Yes, many are the great virtues and blessings and benefits of reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Among them, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned these in the hadith. When you send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. Look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends 10 salawat upon you. When you send one salawat on the Prophet ﷺ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you 10 hasanat, 10 good deeds are recorded for you when you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 10 sayyiat, 10 bad deeds and sins are erased from your records. So you're forgiven, and then that bad deed is erased from your records, never to be heard of about in the dunya and in the akhirah, especially in the akhirah and the day of judgment. And when you send one salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates you 10 degrees higher. You're raised up 10 degrees more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such indeed are the great benefits and blessings of salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In addition to that, your dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you precede your dua with salawat and you end your dua with salawat. So you sandwich your dua in between salawat, as we do in our dua all the time. So at the beginning, hamd and salawat, then make whatever dua you want to make, and then salawat and hamd at the end. In this manner, it's from the adab of dua that your dua, and when you do it like this, your dua is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the dua of salawat, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, you're saying, that dua of salawat is guaranteed acceptance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when it's placed before and after whatever dua you want to make, it raises up your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It elevates your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It takes up your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is accepted in that way. And then the salawat grants you nearness to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of judgment. He says in the hadith, "Awla an-nasi bi yawm al-qiyamati aktharuhum alayya salatan." The closest of people to me on the day of judgment, the nearest of people to me on the day of judgment, are those who are most frequent in reciting salawat upon me. This is the great blessing of reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, you get closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The hadith speaks of the day of judgment, but even in this dunya, you get closer to the Prophet ﷺ every time you recite salawat on the Prophet ﷺ. Closeness in the dunya, closeness in the akhirah. How close do you want to be to the Prophet ﷺ and to his noble Ahlul Bayt and to the Sahabas, the awliya? Yes, how close you want to be to the Prophet ﷺ? You answer that question and then you decide how much salawat you want to recite on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because every time you're reciting salawat, you're getting closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine yourself on the day of judgment, and there are billions of people there, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in the center on the beautiful carriage, the most beautiful carriage you'll ever see, tied to the burak. That's the carriage of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's holding Liwa ul Hamd, the banner of praise that is given on that day of judgment, making him, demonstrating that he is the leader of everything and everyone on that day of judgment. Yes, the Prophet says, how close do you want to be to him? Wouldn't you like for you to be close to him? You can see him and he can see you. Are you close to him? You can see him. You can see the Ahlul Bayt on that carriage with him, the prophetic entourage, Sayyidah Fatima al-Zahra, Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada, Sayyidina Imam Hassan, Sayyidina Imam Hussein, and so on. Ahlul Bayt are there with the Prophet. Of course, we would love to be close to him. And every time you recite salawat, you're getting closer to the Prophet. So I want you to recite salawat as much as you can. As part of this salawat project, every day you recite your salawat on the Prophet ﷺ. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and honor you to be able to recite salawat on his most beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
جشن آمد رسول اللهی الله بی بی آمینا کے پول اللهی الله جشن آمد رسول اللهی الله بی بی آمینا کے پول اللهی الله جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پور و غلما بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلما بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کیا میلے زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کیا میلے زندگی
تو جبریل نے دیئے
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. I want to share with you today this wonderful opportunity to gain much blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the hadith, "Ma naqasa malu 'abdin min sadaqah." The wealth of a person will never decrease because of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning that your wealth will increase when you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you engage in infaq fi sabilillah. Your wealth will increase. And so the opportunity for you to increase your wealth greatly by spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The opportunity I want to share with you is for our live stream broadcast. This broadcast that you have been watching, many of you every day, many of you several times a week. The daily broadcast we have at 7 p.m., the Jummah broadcast at 1 p.m. on Fridays, the special programs, the special maulids, halakas, and so on. So many different programs we have. And many people are benefiting from this program, as you know, many brothers and sisters like yourselves, families from many different countries are benefiting from the live stream broadcast. And we need to acquire new equipment and to update our equipment we have that we are using for the live stream broadcast. And there are several items we need. And the first one I want to share with you today and to appeal to you for this, it's the camera. We need to get a new camera, and the budget for the camera is $6,000. Our wonderful staff here at Islam Forum, they've done their research in this matter, and so we need to acquire that camera, and the cost is $6,000, and we hope you can donate towards this project. We've divided that amount into shares of $100, and so you can donate one share of $100, or five shares, which is $500, or 10 shares, which is $1,000, or more, whatever you can afford, and whatever blessings you would like to receive from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To make your donation, you can go to our website, Islam Forum website at islamicforumonline.com. And then on the donation page, you would see one of the buttons for the different categories of donation labeled live stream equipment. It's the second button in the list of categories for donation. So you click on that button, live stream equipment, and you would make your donations for this specific cause that we are appealing to you for. We hope you can respond generously immediately by donating as many shares as you can, each share being $100, and the total amount we would like to raise for the camera is $6,000. This is the first item we need, and there are several items. We would let you know once we collect the money for the camera, we would go on to the next item, and we let you know the details about that. So do respond, and respond generously, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Once again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ma naqasa malin min sadaqah." Ma naqasa malu 'abdin min sadaqah. The wealth of a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never decreases because they spend in the way of Allah. Their wealth will only increase. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them increase in their wealth. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your entire family and all your loved ones because of your financial support for the Islamic Forum. Ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد My dear respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to this continuing series as we share reflections on the new year, preparing for the new year and threading a spiritually fulfilling path for this new year. We continue to share these gems of wisdom from our book, The Traveler's Light, Misbah al-Salikin. And we mentioned 7 points so far when we talked about the purpose of life and living a life of purpose. And we talked about the power of niyyah, of intention, the power of dua or supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the power of dhikr, the power of love, the power of giving, and the power of choice. I want to continue today by starting off sharing some reflections with the on the theme of or the topic of the power of reflection. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned a hadith which is narrated in the Sunan of Ibn Majah radiallahu anhu, one of the collectors of hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, in which the Prophet is reported to have said, La aqla katadbir. There is no wisdom like reflection. That we should reflect, we should think, we should ponder. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran time and time again. In hadha li ayati li qawmi yatafakkaroon. The signs for men and women of reflection, of intellect. Ulul Albab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the people of intellect, those who reflect and ponder in the Quran. Afala tatafakkaroon, afala tatadabbaroon, and so on and so forth. This invitation to thinking and pondering and reflection. And then, so this power of reflection develops within you a special mindset, thinking for yourself, and that you should think well to live well and avoid the confusion of letting others do the thinking for you. And this, sometimes it sounds surprising to some people that this is actually the focus of the dominant culture in our society. Society wants to do the thinking for people and doesn't want to promote your thinking. And there are many examples like this, and because it's done in such a way that people are unaware of this. For example, the fashion industry tells us what to wear and who to follow as a role model. And people do that because of advertising and promotion and marketing. Certain ideas, certain fashions become so popular that people just want to follow others, keep up with the Joneses, and so on, and not thinking for themselves. The nature of marketing is to take away that thinking for you and push you to act in a certain way. And people believe that they are thinking for themselves and making that decisions for themselves to buy that item or that other item, when they are that decision is generated for them and they follow, that we need to be mindful of. So we must understand that social values keep changing all the time. And so people change from one thing to another thing, and quickly, maybe a month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, different things change. Technology, for example, it's changing so fast, and people have problems catching up with it, but still they have to be in tune with the times, keeping up with the Joneses. So they do that. So they have a phone that's working very well, doing everything they want to do, but then a new model comes out, a new iPhone comes out, and people may not need it, but they want it, because that's advertising that's telling them. And so the release of the iPhone is done in such a way that they tell you that there are limited supplies, for example, a limited edition to be released, and people are lining up in front of the Apple iPhone stores and so on the night before to get their phone, the new phone, whatever that number is, iPhone. There's no consideration given to whether they need it or not. No. The advertising is done so that they want it. And so there is this social engineering of people, and that we need to be mindful. When you're too busy and preoccupied, you won't get a chance to think. You won't get a chance to think. You're busy with doing so many things all day. You lose the opportunity to think. And then in that situation, many people accept changes without questioning or thinking about it. And sometimes the nature of the culture of society is such that it keeps you busy all the time, that you don't get the chance to think. But there is this important concept of what is called fikr. There's dhikr, remembrance of Allah, and fikr, reflection on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's an important connection between dhikr and fikr. So dhikr frees up your mind so that you can think in a way that's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's a powerful tool for you to have. And you must give yourself that opportunity every day for reflection. Reflect on your day. The concept of muhasabah that we would deal with on another occasion when we talk about that point. But thinking about your day, for example, I usually recommend that before you go to sleep at night, take a few minutes, 5 minutes, 4 minutes or so, and think about tomorrow, what you plan to do, and plan to do it. Your things to do list for tomorrow. And then, so you're thinking about your day that's coming, the coming day, what you would do and how you would do it so that it becomes productive to you. And then at intervals throughout that day or at the end of the day, then you evaluate, you see what you've done. Think about what you've done. Think about what you're supposed to do. This reflection, this concept of fikr, that you should engage in maidanul fikr, in the sphere of thinking and reflection that you would do. Always you want to consider your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reflect upon that, where it is. And once again, if you allow yourself to be too busy throughout the day, you wouldn't get a chance to do this. If you allow yourself to be too preoccupied, you wouldn't get that chance to think and to reflect, to engage in fikr. There's dhikr and fikr. Dhikr, engaging in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and fikr, reflecting and pondering and thinking about things that would help you to improve yourself and be better, especially in your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this hadith, in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam reported to have said, there is no wisdom like reflection, and you should think well to live well. Avoid the confusion of letting others do the thinking for you. Think for yourself. That's a powerful weapon you have. And don't allow others to take it away from you. Think for yourself. Yes. What you should, how you should be in your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let us that always be uppermost in your mind as you continue to think for yourself. So the power of reflection and thinking that you should be mindful of. The next point I want to mention is the power of habits, that you should develop and maintain good habits. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned the hadith in the Sunan of Imam At-Tirmidhi in his collection of hadith. He says, "Ittaqillaha haythuma kunta wa atbi'a sayyi'ata al-hasanata tamhuha." Have taqwa, fear of Allah, consciousness of Allah, wherever you may be, however you may be, haythuma kuntum, whether it's a physical place or a situation you're in, haythuma kuntum, wherever you are, however you are, and follow up a bad deed with a good deed, and it will wipe out the effect of the bad deed. So every day is an opportunity to acquire more good habits. You want to develop good habits. And so the Prophet ﷺ is saying here that even if you do something wrong, make sure you follow that up by quickly doing good deeds, have good habits. It would wipe out the or wipe away the effect of that bad deed. Every day, see it as an opportunity for you to develop and do more good habits and maintain those habits. Find out what habits matter the most in your journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that you would develop those habits. Successful people have good habits that they keep doing time and time again. As the saying goes, if the wheel is not broken, don't fix it. Don't try to tamper with it. If it's not broken, it's working well, go with it. And so successful people in this dunya, they develop good habits and they maintain those habits and they become more successful. They achieve success and they keep achieving more success. For example, their books by self-help authors and experts about success in the dunya. And they talk about the 7 successful habits of people, or the 7 habits of successful people. A habit is something you do regularly. Unsuccessful people who fail to achieve their objectives or they want to do, they find habits to be boring. And they say that, you know, why should I do this every day? I did it yesterday. Why should I do it again today? I've been doing it for 1 month. Why should I continue doing it? And so on. They find habits boring. They can't maintain and sustain good actions continuously. But successful people do that. The power of habits, good habits, that you should have and develop and maintain and sustain. And every day, see it as an opportunity to acquire more good habits. And Islam is built on a system of consistent good habits that you do. It's called mudawama. This concept in Islam is called mudawama. So for example, our ritual of prayer, the salah that we perform, we have to perform our salah 5 times every day. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. We have to perform salah 5 times every day. We cannot say that, listen, last week, all week, I did 5 times every day. This week, I'll just take a break. I'll do 4 times a day instead of 5. No, the system is established. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has established his deen. The Prophet alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam showed us that way that we follow. We have to perform every day. We cannot say that, oh, I prayed from Monday to Friday, 5 days in a week, I'll take a vacation. Saturday and Sunday, I would not pray. No, none of that is acceptable. There's a long weekend coming up. Labor Day weekend, Thanksgiving weekend, Christmas weekend, New Year's weekend. Let me take a break from prayer. No, it doesn't work like that. We pray five times a day, every day in our lives. Then, another example. I just want you to understand this concept of mudawama. In Islam, the whole religion, the deen of Islam is based on this concept of developing, maintaining, sustaining good habits in your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in a similar way now, good habits in your dunya, to be successful in your dunya, to maintain these habits. Good people, successful people, maintain good habits every day. They're consistent with it. That's mudawama. To be persistent in consistency. And one of our editors' pick video is actually devoted to that. That we encourage you to look at all our editors' pick video that the staff at Islamic Forum prepared for you. Mudawama. Another example is siyam, fasting. We are required to fast in the month of Ramadan every year. We cannot say that, oh, for the past 5 years, I've been fasting in Ramadan. I'll take a break this year. I wouldn't fast. No, none of that is acceptable. You have to fast. And for those who miss their fast, they must make up their fast for a valid Sharia reason that they miss their fast. Then they make it up. And the law of Islam talks about that and sets down the rules. But this concept of maintaining a good habit. Every year, in the month of Ramadan, we have to fast. And this month moves through the year. Every 33 years, cycles from January to December. It comes forward by 11 days every year. Because the Gregorian year has 365 days, 365 and a quarter. And so every 4 years they correct for that error by adding a day to February. Whereas the Islamic year has 354 days, 11 days less. So that's how it moves forward. So over a period of 33 years, it moves through the entire year. There's some people who say when it's winter time, it's okay, days are short, they'll fast. Summertime, they want to take a break because long days, 16 hours, 17 hours, 18 hours, in some countries, in a northern hemisphere, much longer than that, like this. So it's difficult, but we sacrifice for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This commitment, developing and maintaining good habits. We have to give zakat every year. 2.5% of our net income. We cannot, net savings. We cannot, our net asset. We cannot say that, listen, I gave zakat last year, previous year, on the same money I have. I'm not going to do it this year. No, it's calculated annually. You give zakat last year, that's for last year. It's not for this year. Every year you have to do that. And so on and so forth. The deen is based on this concept of mudawama. Persistence in consistency, to be consistent. In other words, develop good habits. Maintain good habits. Don't be bored by this. Like, for example, the wird alarm, the dhikr. So you have to recite it in the morning and in the evening. Morning and evening, wird alarm, twice a day. You do that every day. Maintain it. And now, when you have good habits, it changes you. It transforms you. Yes. It may be gradual transformation. You may not notice the change in you. But over a period of time, that change happens. And others may notice it. Someone didn't see you for 6 months. And they're seeing you now, how you behave. And they will tell you, you've changed. You're more religious. You're a nice person. You're better than when I met you the last time, six months ago or a year ago. People would notice it because it's a gradual change, and sometimes you don't notice the gradual changes you're making, the gradual improvements you're making. But it happens. So maintain those good habits, Islamic habits, as established by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And also, as I said, every day an opportunity to develop and acquire good habits, more good habits. It is also an opportunity to get rid of bad habits. It is just as important that you acquire good habits and similarly get rid of bad habits. Don't hold on to bad habits. Get rid of it. Let it go, because a bad habit, it's like a weight on your head, a weight on your shoulder, keeping you down, keeping you back from progressing. So bad habits, you get rid of them. Be mindful about that. So the power of habits, good habits, that you should have and you should develop. The next point I want to mention, it is the power of consistency. And this is a development, an outgrowth, a continuation of the previous points. It's a particular type of habit that you should develop. Consistency in doing things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى أَدْوَمَهَا وَإِنْ قَلَّ. Listen to this beautiful hadith from Sahih Bukhari. The most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that deed which is done consistently, regularly, even if it is something small. وَإِنْ قَلَّ. A beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is, so the Prophet is saying that this is an act, a good deed, which is loved by Allah. Ahabul a'mali illahi ta'ala. The deed that's most beloved to Allah. Adwamaha. The one which is done regularly, consistently, in color, even if it is small. I want you to consider this point carefully and seriously. The power of consistency in doing good deeds. That you must be consistent in doing good deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to strive to be consistent in doing good deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, for example, we have the Quran project. This Quran project, a simple commitment to give a few minutes, just a few minutes every day to the Quran, to recite at least one page of the Quran. Start from the beginning, Surah Al-Fatiha, recite that. Surah Al-Baqarah, recite that. Finish it, Surah Al-Imran, recite that. Finish it, Surah An-Nisa, finish it, and so on. Continue until you finish the Quran. So it's a small good deed. One page of the Quran, just a few minutes. Some people who can read fluently, they can finish one page in less than a minute. Some people, 2 minutes or 3 minutes. Those who are reading very, very slow, maybe 5 minutes. Just a few minutes, not too much to recite one page of the Quran. But a small good deed, do it consistently, every day. And then soon enough, a time will come when you will finish the entire Quran. And we witnessed that for this Quran project we launched. And from this project now, the Quran project, recite one page a day, many, many brothers and sisters in many different countries have done their khatam. Many of them say it was the first time they've finished reciting the entire Quran from beginning to end in their life. And then they continue. I tell them, congratulations, continue. Start the next khatam. And they are those who have developed this habit, starting with one page a day, and then they find that they can spend some more time, do 2 pages, 3 pages, 4 pages, 5 pages a day. Like this. Some people reach a level where they're reciting one juz of the Quran every day, 20 pages. And then by the end of the month, they're finishing khatam. There are several brothers and sisters that are doing that. Every month, they're finishing one khatam. Some are doing more than that. Those brothers and sisters whom we have time, they're retired, they're at home, they're not working, and so on and so forth, they have more time. And they're doing several khatams every month. The power of consistency. You have to commit yourself to developing this power of consistency, that you would spend some time every day and through that consistency develop good habits. Remember what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the hadith in Sahih Bukhari, the most beloved deed to Allah is that good deed you do regularly, even if it is a small deed, something small. Yes, you want to strive to develop that consistency, because it builds you. It builds you spiritually, mentally, physically, intellectually, whatever objectives you set your sights upon. Consistency, do that. This power of consistency, mudawama, is the emblem of the believer. The emblem of the believer. The next point I want to mention is the power of connection. The power of connection. Your spiritual connection. I want to share with you one example from this, from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith which is reported by Imam at-Tirmidhi in his Sunan. Prophet alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, أولى الناس بي يوم القيامة أكثرهم علي صلاة. The closest of people to me, or the person closest to me on the day of judgment, is the one who recites most salawat upon me. The one who recites the most salawat upon me. The closest of people, the nearest of people, the most deserving of people to me on the day of judgment is the one who recites the most salawat in this dunya. The power of connection, spiritual connection. So when you're close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what it means that on the day of judgment you're close to him, you're most deserving of him, he would intercede for you. The power of connection. Understand this. The most powerful connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because that leads you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, the shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's the yearning of the believer, the great desire of the believer, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would intercede for us in the akhirah, when nothing that we can do can help us. So we need to understand this power of connection and how it benefits us in our entire existence, in both worlds, in this dunya and in the akhirah. Because when you are connected to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you benefit in this dunya. It is like a noor, a light that shines the way for you, that make it easy for you to deal with the ups and downs of life, the difficulties and sorrows of life, the challenges and trials of life. That love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the power of connection. And when you're connected to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you then become connected to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, the believers love you because of your love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you because of your love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the famous ayah of love, of mahabba, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحِبِّبُكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say to the believers, O Muhammad, if you love Allah, then love me, follow me. Yes. Follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when you do that, yuhibbukumullah, Allah will love you. And more than that, Allah will forgive you your sins.
وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And Allah is most forgiving and most merciful. Yes, the power of connection, your greatest connection is to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that we should be mindful of. So the lesson for us now is to develop and strengthen this power of connection to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And through that sincere connection, then we fashion our lives, we change our lives so that it would be in accordance with the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Yes. So if something you're doing that's not in conformity to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you change it and let your lives conform to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The consequences of connection, the blessings of connection, the benefits of connection, spiritual connection to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that takes you closer to Allah. Because when you love the Prophet, he loves you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you because of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And so be mindful of this amazing concept of spiritual connection to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And two things I want to share with you that would nourish and cultivate this connection. Firstly, salawat. Recite salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as much as you can every day. And we have this salawat project for this purpose. And the second thing is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Every day you practice at least one sunnah. A deliberate decision on your part, identify sunnah, practice a sunnah out of your law for the sunnah, your law for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then every day recite salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, salawat or durood sharif. Pick a particular number and try to maintain that number every day. We recommend for you a minimum of 200 salawat every day. And when you recite a wird al-am, and because we recommend that everyone should recite a wird al-am dhikr in the morning and in the evening, twice a day. And every time you recite a wird al-am, it contains 100 salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So twice a day, that's your 200 salawat. Very simple, very easy. You do that. And if you have more time to do more, you do more. Because every time you're reciting salawat, remember, you're getting closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the dunya and in the akhirah, your connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every time you recite your salawat, you're getting closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He tells us this in this beautiful hadith, in the Sunan al-Tirmidhi, أَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ عَلَيَّ صَلَاتًا. Subhanallah. The closest of people, the nearest of people to me on the Day of Judgment, the one that's most deserving of me on the Day of Judgment, the one who recites more salawat in this dunya. So it's an amazing opportunity for us to get closer and closer to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Salawat on the Prophet in this beautiful, sincere way, with feelings from your heart, you're reciting this salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to develop that closeness. So these are some additional points from our book, The Traveler's Light, Misbahus Salikin. 11 points we've shared with you so far, that inshallah you can practice these points and it would enrich your lives spiritually, mentally, physically, intellectually, in all ways, because that spiritual change is the basis, the foundation of everything. Your spiritual fulfillment, your spiritual change leads to all these other things and bring you happiness beyond imagination in your life, in this dunya, and certainly in the hereafter. And this is my dua for each and every one of you, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you to follow this way, the traveler's light. Let it be a shining light for us, misbahus salikin, and gain ultimate success in this dunya and in the akhirah. Amin, amin, amin. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و دل میں بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پور و دل میں بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
جبریل نے بھی اعلان کیا یہ خدا کے رسول
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
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 محمد زينة الدنيا وبحجتها
محمد كاشف الأمة والظلام
محمد سيد طابت مناكبه
محمد صاغه الرحمن بالنعم
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
محمد شرف الباري مراتبه
محمد خصه الرحمن بالنعم
محمد صفوة الباري وخيرته
محمد طاهر من سعير التهامي
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
محمد ضاحك للضيف مكرمه
محمد جاره والله لم يضام
محمد طابت الدنيا ببعثته
محمد جاء بالآيات والحكم
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
محمد ظهرت فينا هداياته
محمد هديه نورا لكل عام
محمد آمنا إحسان نعمته
محمد سر علم اللوح والقلم
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
نور والا آیا ہے نور لے کر آیا ہے
نور والا آیا ہے نور لے کر آیا ہے سارے عالم میں یہ دیکھو کیسا نور چھایا ہے الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا رسول اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام
محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا
إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد أشرف العرب والعجم محمد خير من يمشي على قدمي محمد بسيط المعروف جامعه محمد صاحب الإحسان والكرم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد تاج رسل الله قاطبة محمد صادق الأقوال والكلم محمد ثابت الميثاق حافظه محمد طيب الأخلاق والشيم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد جبلت بالنور تينته محمد لم يزل نورا من القدم محمد حكيم بالعدل ذو شرف محمد مدين الإنعام والحكم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد خير خلق الله من مضر محمد خير رسل الله كلهم محمد دينه حق ندين به محمد مشرك حقا على عالم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد ذكره روح لأنفسنا محمد شكره فرض على الأمم محمد رحم الله العباد به محمد سبب الإنشاء من عدم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن لعلي وحسين وحسن لعلي وحسين وحسن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا كل من كان محبا لهم كل من كان محبا لهم يدخل الجنة من غير حزن يدخل الجنة من غير حزن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا كل من سار على دربهم كل من سار على دربهم يدخل الجنة من غير حزن يدخل الجنة من غير حزن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أما بعد My dear respected brothers and sisters, once again, we welcome you to our program. We thank you for joining us today for this special broadcast, our daily program, coming to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum of Canada, starting at 7 p.m. Toronto time every day, inshallah. We thank all of you for joining us for the program. We hope you can join us every day at 7 p.m. Toronto time. And do remember to reach out to others, your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know, and tell them of the program. Encourage them to watch the program. Remind them to watch the program. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, we had a wonderful Jummah program earlier today. We hope you are all able to join us, inshallah, and you can type in the chat your feedback from the Jummah program today, the khutbah and so on. Inshallah, we thank you for joining us and we encourage you to be with us every Friday, 1 p.m. for the Jummah broadcast. I focused on this concept of the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through dua. We talked last week about the action plan for this year, 2022, based on the theme that we selected, consistency in commitment to to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So another aspect of that, this action plan is that it should be based on dua. Dua, an integral part of the plan, how we connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from our heart. We outpour our feelings to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever we want to achieve in our life, in this dunya, and especially in the akhirah. So it's a wonderful concept, and I hope inshallah you can implement this by making frequent dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. You want to be making dua to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what you want. And one of the things that we need to be mindful of also is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us to ask Him for things, guide our tongue to say words of dua, guide our heart to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for specific things that you want in dua, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give us that. It's something that we should remember. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give us something, so He guides our heart, our tongues to say this, to beg Him for this. So sincerity in dua, and then the conviction that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer dua. It's a wonderful mindset to have, this mindset of dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He wants, because He is the only one who can give us in reality. And He can do whatever He wants. Nothing is impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also want to thank all the volunteers we had for Jum'ah today and every Friday. We have a group of brothers and sisters that volunteer to help the arrangement, to help to organize the Jum'ah, and to take care of the people who come here. And then the live stream broadcast, the admin staff that takes care of that. We want to make special dua for them as well. And for those of you who are based locally in the Toronto area and you're able to come to the Islamic Forum, then we also want to invite you to join the volunteer team here at the Islamic Forum, that you can help out on Fridays for Jummah, those who, of you who are able to come to the masjid, inshallah. It's a wonderful opportunity to gain much blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you do this khidmah, serve the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, serving Islam, serving the Muslim ummah, then it's one of the most effective ways of progressing on the spiritual journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we want to thank all our volunteers and offer this opportunity for those of you who would like to volunteer. For those of you out of town or in other countries, then for Jum'ah, if you would like to participate in the Jum'ah program, then you can engage in the Dawah project for Jum'ah, which is to invite people, connect with people, and encourage them to join the Jum'ah broadcast on Friday. So you make a list of people you know, and then you remind them, contact them, like Thursday evening, Friday morning, remind them to join us for Jum'ah, inshallah. Especially those who are not able to go to the masjid. There are many like sisters and elderly, our parents, grandparents in the home, children and so on, who are not able to go to the masjid in their own city for Jum'ah, then they can join us, inshallah. So you can play your part in that way. We have a request for dua I want to mention. Brother Muhammad Iftikhar requesting dua for his mother, her first year anniversary since her passing. And his father as well. His mother's name, Sister Begum Imtiaz, daughter of Haji Muhammad Zaman and wife of the late Abdul Qayyum, the father of Sidi Muhammad Iftikhar from Birmingham, United Kingdom. So we want to make special dua for Sidi Muhammad Iftikhar's mother on the first anniversary of her passing, and also his father who passed away a few years ago. We make dua for all of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, inshallah. We also want to remind you, as we thank all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before, the Juma appeal for this week, but then the ongoing appeal for the new year, that you would be able to respond to the new year appeal and make a generous donation. We are requesting and recommended that brothers and sisters and families make a pledge for a full share of $1,000 and take whatever time you need to take to pay that pledge for the New Year campaign or the New Year appeal, inshallah. Among the donors today for Jummah and for the Jummah donation and for other donation as well, Brother Norman Mogul for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and bless his family. Brother Shahid Noor for the Dollar Day campaign. Sister Ruth McGee, Brother Bilal, Brother Elijah from Richmond, Virginia for the Jummah appeal for this week. May Allah bless them. Sister Abida and Sister Shamaila from Manchester, United Kingdom for the Jummah appeal for this week. Siti Shazia Awan and Siti Sara for their donation, inshallah. Dr. Tahir Chowdhury from Connecticut in the United States, Dr. Tahir Chowdhury and his family, for the Jummah appeal, the weekly donation. So we have two options when you go to the donation page, click on the Jummah button. There are two options. One is to the one-time donation for that week, or you can fill out the profile for the weekly donation. So it will automatically process every week, that in case you're busy 1 week, or so, you still get the blessings. The donation is still processed every week. That's a weekly donation for the Jummah appeal, and you can do so on the website, Islam Forum website, inshallah. Sister Nafisa Ali and family from Scarborough also for the Jummah appeal weekly donation. Siti Sadia Chowdhury and family from New York, Siti Jamil, Siti Yasmin, and Siti Sadia and her children, we thank them for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless them. Online biz from the United Kingdom for their monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Brother Mohammed Ibrahim, Sisi Bibi Ibrahim from Florida for the monthly donation to the Islamic Forum. Sidi Sulaiman Rauth and family for the Jummah appeal weekly donation. So the recurring donation for every week for Jummah. Siti Aliya Khan and family from Ottawa for the Jummah appeal weekly donation as well. Alhamdulillah. Sister Zahadun Hussein and family making a donation for the new masjid building fund. Alhamdulillah. Brother Sharjil Farooq and family for the Sadaqa donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Mariam Pardes from Florida, Pembroke Pines in Florida, for the Jummah appeal donation. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless Sister Mariam and her family from Florida. Sister Shamina Owen from Mississauga for the Jummah donation. Brother Rafiq Muhammad and family for the Jummah donation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. Thank them for their donation, inshallah. Brother Mikey Michael Shifaro from the United States for the new masjid building fund. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. Brother Marcus Rushing, his donation to the Islam Forum from United States, Illinois. Sister Habiba Nuruddin Tariq and family for the Jummah donation. Sister Faniza Ishaq and family for the Zakat donation. Sister Kafilat Adiyinka and family for the Jummah donation. Sister Brenda Williams for the donation to support the live stream broadcast. We thank Sister Brenda Williams from Harlem, New York, in the United States for her regular and generous donation to the Islam for Mila Swantal, bless her and enrich her many, many more times. Sister Yasmin Narain, we thank her and family for her donation to the Islamic Forum, and also she requests dua for her new grandson. So we want to make dua for the grandson, new grandson of Sister Yasmin Narain. Alhamdulillah, congratulations on the birth of the baby, and make dua for the baby and the parents and the grandparents, the entire family. So thanks to Yasmin Narain for your donation to the Islamic Forum. Alhamdulillah. Sister Shakila Majid from Florida, Siti Wajma Wardak, Siti Rashid Walizada from Markham, Sister Shamila Hamid from Woodstock. We thank them for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Alhamdulillah. Brother Patrick Wilson and family from Mississauga, we thank Brother Patrick Wilson for his donation to the Islamic Forum. Alhamdulillah. Sister Crystal Ramkisoon, we thank them for their donation, the entire family, for their donation to the Islamic Forum. Alhamdulillah, the Jummah donation. Sister Crystal Ramkisoon, make dua for them and the entire family. Brother Najib Mateen and family, for the Sadaqah donation to the Islamic Forum. Sister Carol Shearer from Austell in Georgia in the United States. We thank Sister Carol Shearer for the New Year appeal. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for making the donation for the New Year appeal. It's very nice. Also, Sister Isma Ginger Campbell and family, for the donation to support the live stream broadcast. Alhamdulillah. These are some of the names that we want to mention tonight as we make dua for all our donors, all those who donated today, yesterday, and before. We include all of them in dua, inshallah. Alhamdulillah. So those are our donors. We make special dua for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enrich them many more times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase their rizq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barak in their wealth and bless them, bless their family, bless their loved ones because of their donation to the Islamic Forum, inshallah. And so once again, please enter your information in the chat, your name, the city where you're from, the greetings. So tonight, Jummah Mubarak greetings, and Jummah al-Ula, Jummah al-Thaniya, sorry, for the Islamic month, the greetings, you can put that there, inshallah. Sister Yasmin Narain, she was blessed with her grandson, new grandson, make dua for them, inshallah. So all those you can extend congratulations. In the chat as well, included there is, this is the book that we are featuring for this time of the year, Blessings of Salawat. So there's a link in the chat, or you can go directly to Amazon.com website and type in the search box, type in the name of the book, Blessings of Salawat by Sheikh Faisal. You'll be able to get your book, inshallah. And this is a wonderful gift item that we recommend. You can get extra copies and give it to your loved ones and other people you know and so on. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the book. It has wonderful gems of wisdom that would introduce them in a beautiful way to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This relationship with the Prophet, relationship salawat, that we recite all the time to get great blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So once again, we recommend that you get this book for yourself and get additional copies for others that you can give to them as a gift, inshallah. At the top of the chat today, we welcome Sister Hafiza Hamid Ali, Brother Abbas Ali, and family from Pinal in Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome, thanks for joining us. Sister Zairul and family from Toronto, Quran Project, IFC Quran Project, up to Chapter 3, IFC Salawat Project, 1,000 today for a total of 5,800 Salawat for this year, 2022, so far. Auntie Betty Amina Dean from Toronto, Salawat Project, 1,000 Salawat today for a total of 6,000 Salawat. Alhamdulillah. Brother Keith McDonald, Sister Ola, Brother Juan from Toronto. Welcome to all of you, inshallah. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. Siti Lazina Kharmular and family from Pinal in Trinidad in West Indies. Welcome to you. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Farida Chan, Brother Sama Chan from Miami, Florida. Welcome. Alhamdulillah, thanks for joining us. Says grateful to Allah SWT for all the blessings showered on us. IFC Salawat Project, 200 Salawat today for a total of 1,700 Salawat for the year 2022 so far. IFC Quran Project, complete up to chapter 24. Very nice, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Zamino Razak and family from Cotton Tree Village, West Coast, Barbies in Guyana, South America. Welcome all the way from South America. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Shamir, Sidi Samir, Sidi Amir, Sidi Shabir, Sidi Shafir, Sidi Shazia, Sidi Sadika, Sidi Alima. All from Queens, New York, United States. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Hasib, Sidi Asian family from Brampton. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. May Allah bless you. Alhamdulillah. Sister Razia Khan, Brother Tariq Feroz from Scarborough. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. May Allah SWT bless you. Sidi Safraz Muhammad and family from California Halakha in Trinidad in West Indies. Welcome, Sidi Safraz. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. We hope you can join us every day, inshallah. And do reach out to the Murids and encourage them to watch the program. Sign into the chat, inshallah. Those in the California area can come over to your place and look at the program, inshallah. You get a lot of blessings for doing so. Sidi Zahid Ihsan from San Diego in the United States. Welcome, Sidi Zahid. Thanks for joining us. Sister Ullah Rahman and family watching from Guyana. And Sister Rose watching from Florida. Alhamdulillah. We hope you're enjoying your vacation there, inshallah. Keep safe. And may Allah protect you there, inshallah. And then the Muslims you meet there when in Guyana or in Florida, you tell them about the program, encourage them to watch the program, sign into the chat, show them how to access the channel, share the link with them, youtube.com/Sheikh Faisal/live, inshallah, that they can watch the program, inshallah, you'll receive more blessings. Afwan, excuse me. You receive more blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See Zahir Ihsan, IFC Salawat Project, 1,300 Salawat today for a total of 3,000 for the year 2022 so far. Alhamdulillah, very nice. Sister Bibi Ibrahim, Brother Muhammad Ibrahim, Brahman Rani and family from Pembroke Pines in Florida, welcome. Alhamdulillah, says grateful to Sheikh Faisal for the Jummah Khutbah today. And for all the blessed programs, Alhamdulillah, may Allah increase your blessings, and we thank you for your donation to the Islamic Forum as well. Siti Sabiha Qadir, Siti Kamran and Sarah from Columbus, Ohio in the United States, welcome to all of you. Thanks for joining us, Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you. Siti Amirul Muhammad, Sidi Azad and family from Pinal, Halakha and Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. We hope you can join us every day, inshallah. Sis Abed and Sis Shamayala and family from Manchester, United Kingdom. Welcome and wishing Jumada Thani Mubarak greetings to everyone. Alhamdulillah. Very nice. Quran Project. Today we've read Juz number 1 to 5, Alhamdulillah, and Salawat Project, 25,000 Salawat. So last night, Sis Abdan, Sis Shamayla did the Khatam of the Quran, very nice, Alhamdulillah, another Khatam for the IFC Quran Project. And Sis Abdan Shamayla says, Gratitude Project, we are grateful for the Jummah Khutbah today by Sheikh Faisal. Small deeds done consistently are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very true. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sister Ambreen Yaqub, Brother Muhammad Yaqub and family from the city of Chelam in Pakistan. Welcome all the way from Pakistan. Make dua for you, your family, your brother, as requested, inshallah. Brother Sheikh Abdul from Port Louis in Mauritius. Welcome all the way from Mauritius, Brother Sheikh Abdul. Thanks for joining us. And do remember to reach out to other Muslims there in Mauritius and tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch the program and sign into the chat, inshallah. Brother Ahsan Shabir and family from Italy, welcome. All the way from Italy, we make dua for you and your family. Alhamdulillah, thanks for joining us from Italy. And Sister Raja Khan says, Sister Bibi Muhammad just passed away, returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're very sorry to hear this. Last night we announced it on the program. We made dua for her. She was critically ill. Today she passed away. Jum'ah, it's a good sign. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless her with Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her and have mercy on her. Inshallah, Sister Bibi Muhammad, the relative of Sister Razia Khan. Also the cousin of Sheikh Moeen in Guyana. So we want to, and Sister Razia, please convey our condolences and sympathies to the entire family of Sister Bibi Muhammad, inshallah. Until you make dua for Sister Bibi Muhammad and for all the family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with sabr, inshallah. And thanks for letting us know. And you can also update us maybe tomorrow about janazah and so on, inshallah. Sidi Rahim, Sidi Riyana, Sidi Bibi and family from Prisal, Halak and Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome to all of you, alhamdulillah. Brother Muhammad Feroz and family from Mississauga, welcome. Brother Muhammad Feroz, thanks for joining us. Sidi Edwina Hussein, Sidi Zalia, Sidi Zurida from Pinal in Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome to all of you, alhamdulillah. Sidi Abdul Wahab Abrahams from Cape Town, South Africa. Welcome to the program, Sidi Abdul Wahab. Thanks for joining us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And Sidi Wahab, Abdul Wahab Abraham said, recited the Weird Alarm three times today and five times Tasbih of the Tasbih of Sayyidah Fatima Zahra, recited five pages of the Quran. Alhamdulillah, very nice, alhamdulillah. A lot of ibadah today, Sidi Abdul Wahab. Continue great work you're doing. And try to reach out to others and encourage them to recite the Weird Alarm. Focus on the Weird Alarm dhikr. Others, other Muslims that you know, especially the young Muslims, try to get them to recite the Weird Alarm, inshallah. Sister Mariam McGee, Brother Elijah, Brother Bilal from Richmond, Virginia. Welcome to all of you and wishing Jummah Dathani Mubarak greetings and Jummah Mubarak greetings to everyone. Alhamdulillah, very nice. Sister Shireen Jabbar and family from Scarborough. Welcome, Sister Shireen. Thanks for joining us. May Allah bless you. Alhamdulillah. And Brother Elijah Muhammad, 10 years old, he says, today my grandmother helped me with the words of the daily dhikr and helped me with the salawat. Alhamdulillah, very nice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the question you asked, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not created by anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was always in existence. He's describing the Quran, who will awwalu wal akhiru, and so on. He's the first that ever existed, and there was nothing before him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all of us and everything in existence. Thanks for your question, Brother Elijah Muhammad. 10 years old, mashallah, interacting well with the program. May Allah bless you more and more. Siti Aliya Khan and family from Ottawa, welcome. And Siti Aliya wishing Jumma Mubarak greetings and Jumma Dathaniya Mubarak greetings to everyone. Shukran Siti Aliya, may Allah bless you. Sister Roxana Begum and family from Brampton, welcome. And IFC Quran Project up to Sultan Nahal. IFC Salawat Project, 3,000 Salawat today for a total of 24,000 Salawat. Alhamdulillah, very good. Make dua for you and your family. Sister Halima Khan and family from Markham. Welcome, Sister Halima. Thanks for joining us and wishing the entire IFC family Jumma Dathani Mubarak greetings, Jumma Mubarak greetings, and Happy New Year. Best wishes for health and happiness and prosperity for everyone. May Allah grant the IFC family goodness in this world and the hereafter. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for your dua. May Allah bless you more. Inshallah. And Sister Halima Khan says, today, IFC Salawat Project, 5,000 today for a total of 40,000 Salawat so far for the year 2022. Very nice. You're making good, great progress. IFC Quran Project, Surah number 15 recited. And recited Weird Alam Dhikr and other Dhikr. Alhamdulillah, very nice. And Sister Halima says, thank you, Sheikh Faisal, the Murids, the admin staff, for this blessed daily live stream broadcast. This program that we learn so much from every day and the opportunity to participate and learn in the company of a pious Sheikh, Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless you more, Sister Halima. And Sister Mara says, Sheikh Faisal, first I apologize for all the questions every day, but can you explain Zakat and when to do it? So no need to apologize. We encourage people to ask questions. You know, you write down your questions whenever they come to mind throughout the day and so on. Then in the evening, you ask one question. Inshallah, we answer that. Every day, you know, you can ask a question like this. And then you can do one question per day. So that's why in your notebook, you can write down all the questions that come to your mind. And then you select one every day, you ask that question, we can answer it. So the question tonight is about Zakat. Can you explain Zakat? When to do it? So Zakat is the annual charity that Muslims are required to give. So annual meaning once a year. So for that year, you would calculate your assets, what you have, the net assets, meaning total asset minus your liabilities, so your net assets, and you have to pay 2.5% of that in Zakat. It can be done any time in the year, but we usually recommend that you do it in the month of Ramadan because of the extra blessings you get for doing it in Ramadan. Some people prefer to do it every month. Whatever they get every month, they just pay 2.5% of that, so they are not left behind or they don't miss the payment of the Zakat. But let's say you have $100,000 worth in assets, things that you own, after taking out what you owe, like loans and other things that you have to pay. Let's say you have $100,000, so 2.5% of that. For each $100, it's $2.50. So for $1,000, it's $25. Sorry, $100, 25. And now let me go back with the calculation. So $100, 2.5% means $2.50. $1,000 multiplied by 10, $25. So you calculate your Zakat, how much you have to pay, and you do that once a year. And every year Zakat is payable. So if you have the same assets, like same savings in the bank and so on, every year, then you have to pay once per year, every year, inshallah, for the Zakat. And as I said, Ramadan is a good time, but you can pay it any time in the year. Some people prefer to do it regularly, as soon as they get their money, their salary every month and so on, they take a 2.5% of that to ensure that they are paying their zakat, inshallah. So, and as you know, this is one of the pillars of Islam, one of the five pillars of Islam. So it's very important. It's an act of worship, an act of ibadah. And I usually remind people that you should pay your zakat. Don't think about the 2.5% you're paying. Think about the 97.5% Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows you to keep and blesses you with that. So the blessings, when your wealth has blessing in it, then it's very beneficial for you. You benefit from it tremendously when there's barakah and blessing in your wealth. You're able to do so much with it. But when you don't have barakah and blessing in your wealth, it comes and it goes easily. It comes and it goes, and you don't know where it's gone. There's nothing to show for it because it doesn't have barakah. So when you give your zakat, it brings barakah to your wealth, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with that wealth. That's a brief answer. I hope that answers your question, inshallah. Let us know, please. Thanks for the question, Sister Mariam. And don't hesitate to ask questions. Sister Brenda Williams and family from Harlem, New York, welcome to all of you, alhamdulillah. And wishing Jummah Mubarak greetings to everyone. Sister Brenda Williams says, thanks for another inspirational Jummah khutbah today. The content was heartfelt. Alhamdulillah. Blessings to Sheikh and admin staff. Salawat to the 11 for a total of 380,000. So, Sister Brenda Williams, the total number, you cannot include the number from 2021. What you achieve up to December 31st, you keep that separate. That's your total number for 2021. And then you start a new count for 2022, for the past 7 days, what you've done. Like you did 1100 today, added to what you did for the last 6 days, from the 1st of January. So it's a new count for the Salawat project. So everyone, please pay note to that, take note of that. And Sister Brenda Williams did for Quran project up to Surah number 20, very nice. Sister Bibi Rasool and family from Etobicoke, welcome. I make dua for you and your family, alhamdulillah. And Sister Bibi says, Sheikh, can you explain how dua is important? So the khutbah today was based on that. There are many important points I mentioned in the khutbah today. So please go back to the YouTube channel and listen to the khutbah today. It will tell you much about that. And inshallah, we'll continue to talk much about dua. So dua is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in Quran, Udu'uni astajib lakum. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He answers our dua. He's near to us when we call on Him. إِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ دَعِي إِذَا دَعَانِي. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers our dua, or he answers it in a way that He wants to, which is best for us. So He answers our dua at the time of His choosing, not at the time that we choose or we want. Because what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows is best for us, that what He grant us in dua, inshallah. So the dua is always accepted, sometimes in different ways. So you always want to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. So once again, please look at the khutbah again today, because the khutbah was based on dua, the importance of dua. Inshallah, you'll do it. And then once you listen to the khutbah, if you have any questions, let us know tomorrow night or so, inshallah. Sidi Maulana Tariq Al-Faisal, Sidi Karina Al-Faisal from QREP in Trinidad in West Indies. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. As Sister Mariam says, a beautiful lecture tonight by Sheikh Faisal, alhamdulillah, and a beautiful khutbah today for Jummah, alhamdulillah. Brother Muhammad Ali Habib and family from Karachi, Pakistan, welcome. Recited Wird Al-Am after Fajr, after Maghrib, alhamdulillah. Quran Majid project of the Juz number 26, very nice, alhamdulillah. Sidi Ayan Khan, Sidi Mashur Khan, Mashhood Khan, Siti Rida, Siti Kawal Khan, all from Karachi, Pakistan. Welcome to all of you. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. And Siti Ayan says 800 salawat today for a total of 3,500 salawat. So, Brother Muhammad Ali Habib, you need to correct your number for the salawat. Do not include the count for 2021. You start a new count from zero for the year 2022, inshallah. And admin staff, if you can make a note of this so you can respond immediately to Sidi Brother Muhammad Ali Habib about the count for the salawat as soon as he enters the number, so he will notice it, inshallah. Because I mentioned this last night again, but still he did not change a correct number, inshallah. Sister Mary McGee asked a question, are people allowed to visit the Prophet's burial site? Yes, this is one of the greatest visits you can engage in. So the Prophet alayhi salam is buried in Medina. His maqam is now part of the Prophet's masjid in Medina. So millions of people go there every year to visit the masjid of the Prophet and visit the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they give him salams and recite salawat upon him and so on. And because he is the best of creation in all of creation, that visit is the greatest visit, to visit the best of creation, visit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I make dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you that sometime in the future you can go and visit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Medina, in the blessed city of Medina, and Brother Bilal, Brother Elijah and so on, inshallah. As his Bibi says, your prayer and dua is in sajda. No, that's not correct. You can make dua at any time. You just have to be mindful where you're getting your knowledge from, because then you'll become confused. Sister Mari, make the note of the questions you can ask. The question tomorrow night. Don't ask like all the questions one night. Write it down in your notebook and ask one or two questions every night, inshallah, so we have enough time to answer the question properly. Admin staff, did you see this comment here? But see, you're checking on that, inshallah. Okay, the admin staff is checking on that. Issue, Sister Mariam. Thanks for letting us know. And Sister Halim as well, thanks for your feedback. And if it's better now, let us know as well in the chat. And Sister Halim says, deepest condolences to Razia and family on the passing of her relative. Sister Mariam McGee expressing deepest condolences to Razia and family, from the McGee family in Richmond, Virginia. Shukran, thanks. Siti Shazia Awan from Manchester, United Kingdom, welcome. And says, beautiful Jummah Khutbah today, alhamdulillah. Shukran, thanks for your feedback, everyone. And we'll make dua now for everyone, inshallah, for everyone in the chat, make special dua for them. For the sponsors of the dinner program this month of Jumad Athaniya, special dua for them. And then for all our donors, we make special dua for all our donors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enrich them many more times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase them in rizq, put barak in their wealth, and bless them and bless your family and loved ones because of their donations to the Islamic Forum. So special dua for all our donors. And do remember, tonight also, the Jummah appeal for this week. So you can get that opportunity for blessings and the ongoing appeal for the new year, 2022, that you would make a special donation, a generous donation for the new year. The button is on the website, on the donation page, New Year Appeal. And we're requesting families to make a pledge of a full share of $1,000 And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them for doing so. And you can take whatever time you need to take. In small amounts, you can pay that pledge. But once you make your niyyah, you start getting your blessings, inshallah. Inshallah. Alhamdulillah. And then for each and every one of you, whatever dua you like to make, put that knee in your heart, and we make the dua on your behalf. So kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. A'udhu billahi as-sameel al-aleem min ash-shaytan ar-rajeem. Bismillahi r-Rahmani r-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Maliki yawm al-deen. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqeem. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وقوت الأرواح وغذائها وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأحوال والآفات وتقضي لنا بها جميع الحاجات وتطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات وترفعنا بها عندك أعلى الدرجات وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات في الحياة وبعد الممات وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase you in tawfiq and kubul and ziyada. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. And Sister Razia, thanking everyone for the messages of condolences. Alhamdulillah. And expressing congratulations to Sister Yasmin Orion on the birth of her grandson. Alhamdulillah. Thanks very much, Sister Razia. Very nice. Once again, thank you for joining us for the program today. We hope you can join us every day, 7 p.m. Toronto time. And please remember to tell others, family members, relatives, friends, and other Muslims you know about the program. Encourage them to watch the program. Encourage them to sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So thanks to all of you once again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you always in the shade of His special mercies. Until we meet again, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.